Thank you. Thanks, bro. You coming back?
To a login page, if you've never registered with HubDoll before, make sure that you click the box that says this is the first time you've signed into HubDoll. Feel good? Everybody's logged in? Yes? Okay. So, the next page will be a brief instructions page. This page will also have the script, and then you can begin dialing voters. Once you click Let's Get Started.
No longer appoint bundlers or fundraisers to ambassadorships. Would you be willing to make that same commitment?
I'll certainly commit that anybody I appoint to any position will be qualified and somebody who will do a good job serving the United States.
So you don't think that we need to end that
process? Stacey Abrams has made the issue of voter suppression top on her list. You're here at this bank today. Talk about how important that is to any Democratic
government. Well, democracy is crucial, not just as a system, but as a value. The idea that every vote should be counted and that every voter counts. There is a lot of evidence that voter suppression has changed the outcome of elections. I believe if it weren't for that voter suppression, Stacey Abrams would be the governor of Georgia right now. Everybody living in America has a stake in making sure that elections are free and fair. And what these volunteers are doing right now, reaching out to people who may have been purged, letting them know their rights, is inspiring because this is what it's going to take to make our democracy more democratic.
Mayor, at the debate last night, you, in response to one of these questions about your appeal to black voters, made the point that as a gay man, the struggles of gay Americans is similar to that of other minorities.
I don't know if I would say similar. What I would say is that anyone who has experienced exclusion, anyone who has faced discrimination, anyone who has seen their rights come up for debate, knows the importance of standing up for others who have experienced exclusion.
Forgive me for not
country.
Characterizing it properly, but this morning after you left that breakfast down the street, one of your competitors, Senator Harris, suggested that that kind of explanation is a bit naive, that, you know, to compare or to put the struggles of LGBTQ Americans alongside those of African Americans. I'm just curious what you make of that.
I think this is a time for solidarity. And anyone who's experienced whatever personal struggle we bring to this fight needs to reach into that as motivation to help others. I'm very mindful of the fact that rights were expanded in my life because of not just the advocacy of people like me, but allies who are different from me who also came to the fight. And now is the time for us to unite. Now is the time for us to stand and support one another. And that will continue to be my message, one of inclusion and one of belonging.
Do you understand why Senator Harris would call the equating of the black experience with the experience of being a gay man naive?
Well, first of all, there's no equating those two experiences. And some people, by the way, live at the intersection of those experiences. What I do think is important is for each of us to reveal who we are and what motivates us. And it's important for voters to understand what makes me tick, what moves me, and my sources of motivation in ensuring that I stand up for others. And last night I shared that some of my sources of motivation include my personal experience, my governing experience, and my personal faith.
Mayor, how concerned are you about the threat of voter suppression had been in 2020? Obviously, you talked about the threat in 2018 and the consequences of that with Stacey Abrams. But how concerned are you about that headed into next year?
Very concerned. We know that there is not only interference coming from overseas our way, once again, but also right here at home. There are some in politics who have decided the best way for them to win is to make sure that not as many people get to vote. That's why the work that these volunteers are doing is so critical. That's why defending our elections is so critical. And we need reform so that in the future, you don't have a situation where somebody is a referee in their own match, like what happened with Brian Kemp.
Do you feel like the broader cross-section of the American electorate understands what makes you tick?
Well, that's my job. You know, some have said that a political campaign is an MRI of the soul. And my goal is to ensure that by the time the voting and the caucus begins, there can be no question, not just about where I stand on issues, but who I am and why I care so much about those concerns.
You were at Morehouse College this week. Bernie Sanders is going to be there today. Elizabeth Warren is going to be in Clark, Atlanta later on today. What do you think that says about the role of historically black colleges and really the black vote really coming into focus this week?
Well, it's so important to engage with students and faculty at HBCUs because these are institutions that are creating the next generation of leadership at a time when we still see such underrepresentation of black professionals in fields from medicine to politics to tech. And ensuring that we have more equity and create more economic opportunity begins with supporting HBCUs. So I really valued the opportunity to visit Morehouse to connect with the students who came to speak to us. And I'm glad that HBCUs are getting their due and more attention than I think I've ever seen in political campaigns.
Can you win the nomination without boosting your numbers among black and Latino voters?
This isn't just about politics or how to win. This is about deserving to win. And for me, it is critically important that this be a campaign that draws in a broad coalition of support from people of every background in this country.
Just on the ambassador point, do you not think there needs to be an end to this practice of appointing bundlers, donors to diplomatic positions, especially given the testimony of Gordon Sondland and questions over